tonight's dual county league matchup, Clash of the Titans. It's the Andover Warriors against your Acton Boxborough Colonials. And John, this is the first of three stops on our march to the DCL Championship.
Absolutely, I know. It doesn't get any easier from this point on. We got Billerica, Westford, Reuben, and Arlington.
Cardarelli moves it out of the zone, picked up by Missouri.
Ooh, nice little cross-ice pass.
Roach meets resistance at the blue line.
Uh-oh. And he plays the body nicely.
Cardarelli digs it out of the corner. Oh, and fires it right back to one of the Andover.
Ooh, that's a high stick. Oh, he got it. He got it. Good call. Good call.
High stick on the play.
Good call, Blue.
Face off in the Colonials attacking zone.
So right now, Mikey, as we stand, Andover is number one in the DCL with a better in-league record than AB, even though AB has a better record overall. AB 11-4 and run, Andover 8-5-2. So this is a big game for AB right here. Uh-oh, heads up.
This is, and honestly, John, I think even though we lost to them 2-0 last time we played, I feel like my totally unbiased opinion is we outskated them.
Oh, big time. Big time. I think we had 40
shots.
And
here comes Barrett.
Oh, nice dish.
And here's a chance for Keith.
Oh, and Keith almost hit the rebound back in. Nice goal scorer's play.
What a save by Smith.
Mikey, that was a nice goal scorer's play. Followed right through the net, put a tip on that, almost kicked it home.
McCready's controls for the Colonials, fires it back in.
That's going to be
icing on the play. So there'll be a face-off in the Colonials' defensive end.
I'll tell you, that was a nice play right there, and it's good to see the Colonials coming out flying.
First scoring chance early in the game, and as we've talked about all season, John, the way these girls start kind of sets the tone for the rest of the game.
Yeah, this season it's been pretty much a slow start game after game, but then they get it going. It would be good to get
Cardarelli
them
going. Cardarelli up
nice
the boards
pass.
To Cardarelli in the middle. Chips it in.
Oh, what a dish. That was an incredible dish by Leah over to Elena. Look at them
and
chase back.
And here come the Warriors on the move. And not a lot of speed on that skater. She was caught by three of the Colonials moving up the ice, John.
The passing looks pretty crisp right now. Oh, shots.
That's trouble in front of the net. Cleared out by Missouri.
Good play by Annie. Good block in front. Poke check. Always a beautiful thing.
The Colonials having a hard time controlling the puck in their own end, but now Missouri wheels out of the zone.
There goes
with
Elena.
Speed.
Elena's flying. Oh, we got a break there on the tip.
And here's fresh legs for the Colonials.
Uh-oh. She okay? Elena's up. She went flying in there.
And these games against the Warriors always seem very physical to me.
Yeah, they're a tough team.
Collected by Keith.
Coach Greg Manny plays them tough. He skates four lines, Mikey. He'll roll four lines. He just keeps throwing them out there.
Controlled by Keith behind the net. Pong out front.
Oh, baby.
Intercepted by the Warriors.
That was a nice play. Oh, good hold by Melissa. Good use of the feet, Mikey.
Wong on the, no, it's Keith on the forecheck.
There we go.
By let it go. Here comes Wong. She's going to let one go from the top of the circle.
Stopped
doesn't make it through.
Typical what a lot of teams do against us, Mikey, is they bottle it up in front
Barrett
of the net.
Barrett controls the puck, looking for the regroup.
Dump and change.
Keith dumps it in deep,
change.
And the Colonials go for fresh legs.
Smart play.
Oh, look at that.
Ooh, Minky
on the
Johnny.
Line change. Sneaky Megan Barrett down there, almost stuffed one in.
Ooh, nice kick save by Cal, booted into the side.
Flashes the pad and kicks it off into the corner, and here comes Roach.
Tough bouncing puck right there,
puck
Mikey.
Not bouncing the Colonials' way just yet.
Let's see, a little bounce maybe? No? Oh, Allie McCready just standing him up. Allie had a little bout with a little, headaches, a little concussion syndrome maybe.
She got a little whack against Jones, but she's fine now.
Oh,
Missouri handles it coming out of the zone. Pass the Roach, and here she comes with a head
fiddles,
of steam.
Diddles. The mayor of Dangle City.
McCready's collects it and skates up ice. fires at the Roach.
Playing it safe.
Heads for the bench.
Oh.
Intercepted by Wong out front. There's Barrett with a shot, just wide.
They're getting shots, Mikey. They're getting shots. Smith hasn't made a lot of saves yet. But she's made a couple of quality ones. Nice hold by
Alex. LaBlondo holds it on the blue line.
Oh, good poke check. And as you know, this is play for the cure, Mikey. So proceeds from this
Melissa
game
McCready go to stringing up the boards,
breast
gets
cancer.
To the net.
Ooh.
Oh! Tough low angle shot saved by Smith.
Had a lot of weight on that shot though, didn't it?
Don't tough like, angle, but it's always good to get the puck to the net, Sean.
Oh, absolutely. And if you got a rebound. Last game we played these guys, they scored two goals in the first period, and then we dominated them second and third.
Yeah, one small detail. We didn't get any pucks in the net.
Yeah, I know. We got one in.
Missouri controls.
That's offside.
Offside's on the play. Packed house tonight here at NVO.
Yeah.
Snow day today. Everybody's got their homework buttoned up and is here at the rink.
Susan B. Coleman, play for the cure. All the money. So we'll be sending some money over to cancer after this game.
Maggie Batez getting a shift for the Colonials on D.
Looks like AB, I don't want to talk too early, but looks like AB's D is like geared up for this game.
Roach bumped off the puck.
Nice play by Leah. Is she going to get it off? Oh, Minky and Johnny. Oh!
Right on the doorstep, saved by Smith.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Batez collects, fires over to Cartarelli, and here comes Leah. Bomb with a bomb wide.
And we got a new set of D coming out. Roachy on the back check. Nice job.
And based on what I've seen so far, I have no idea how they beat us the first time, John.
Yeah, but you never know. It's that one
breakaway.
There
comes Barrett with the puck out of the zone. Chips it up the Wong.
Oh, that probably should have been a whistle. Nice job, Melissa.
Whoa. Melissa just bumped off the puck.
Oh, can she take the corner? Nice job by Alex to push it to the
LaBlondo
corner.
LaBlondo steers her wide harmlessly into the corner.
A lot of action.
McCready's battling in the corner.
Mikey,
comes out with the puck.
The pace of this game seems
fast.
Wraps
it up to Wong. Battling along the boards. Wong and McCready still battling.
Nice
job. Here comes Wong with the puck.
That might be a little bit too... Oh, they're
waving
it off.
The icing.
They're waving it off. Oh, a swing and a miss.
Misplayed in the corner by Andover, and there's Wong to apply pressure.
Uh-oh. No call. Thank God. Oh, let it go, baby. Oh, good job. Nice, good hands by Missouri.
And here comes Keith, taking on three Warrior defenders. Trickles one to the net, misplayed by Smith, almost goes in.
I'm telling you, last game.
And here comes Cartarelli on the forecheck.
That's through, that should be an ice.
Ref has his arm up for icing. It'll be a face-off in the Colonials attacking end. John, what do you got so far?
I don't know. I remember last game, Smith had a bunch of saves. Some of them she didn't see. You know, so, and it seems like what's happening tonight is pretty much the same thing.
Cartarelli on the draw, back to Roach. Back to McCready's, who lets a wrist shot go.
Can she get it there?
At the point.
Nice
held
play.
In, though.
Ooh, that might have been offside, no? Oh, Roach, he's taking it to distance.
Roach sticks up in the air. Cartarelli gets it to the net. Handled
gets it
by
Atlanta.
Cartarelli.
Oh, nice
front to
pass
Roach.
To Roach. Nobody home.
Ooh, puck loose.
I'm telling you, Smith is having a tough time
Leah controlling
Cartarelli
that puck. Leah Cartarelli tussling behind the net. Sticks
jam
high
it
in
home.
The air. And who's getting called on the interference?
I don't know. There was an AB player down, so maybe... One of the Golden Warriors is going to go to the bench. Oh, Roachy? Roachy.
And it looks like Lauren Roach headed into the sin bin. I totally missed it, Sean. It must have been behind the play.
I think it was in front of our eyes, but that's not surprising for us to miss it.
I don't see any penalties on the Colonials.
Me neither.
It's just the way I don't see Brickley calling them out against the Bruins either. All right, so penalty killers on the ice for the Colonials.
Right in front of the net. They're going to put
the Warriors working around the perimeter.
Oh, she's away. I'll tell you, they're going to put number 22, the captain
Missouri
of the Golden
controls.
Warriors. And she's just going to stand there right in front of that. She's a big...
Sent the length of the ice by Missouri. Keith.
Big target.
Chases it down. Time on the call, 7 minutes, 44 seconds.
Oh, Missouri, nice play.
And Missouri was kind of in between there. Should she go for it or not? But managed to get her stick on it.
She's like just holding, she's like holding gloves and bouncing people around.
53 seconds left on the shorthanded situation.
Quickly around and quickly take a look. Get your eyes up.
6:32 to go in the game.
Nice job by Alex to get that down the ice.
41 seconds left on the shorthanded situation for the Colonials.
We got a
and
three
here
on
comes
two
a three
right
on
now.
Two.
To the net, Alex, behind you. Nice job.
And six blows a tire in the corner. It's 15, actually.
If you add nine to it.
Cardarelli collects it, pins it along the dasher, killing valuable seconds off the power play.
Nice poke check. Get out of there.
Saved by LaBlunda in traffic. Penalty over.
Where is it? Oh, fiddles diddles.
LaBlunda skates it out of the zone. Sets her edges. Gets leverage.
Oh. If Elena only knew that that was going to squirt through.
Nice Elena job. Taking on three Warriors in the corner.
Somebody should get to the net. If there's three
in
there
to help. Battling, still battling.
The Golden Warriors come out with it. Nice.
And here comes
Roach. Too bad.
Oh.
They're going to dump and change. We should probably get a change right now, too.
And here we go. Nobody on the ice. And LaBlundo's got to let it fly. There she is.
Oh, nice play. Let it go.
To
let
Long,
it go.
Long gets the shot off at the dot. And in comes Barrett on the forecheck.
That's a tough shot for a small kid from the dot.
Is it my imagination, John? Does this Andover team look like they're standing still? The Colonials just have so much more speed.
Oh, mink you, Johnny.
Missouri steams out of the zone with the puck.
Pass it. Skate it in. There you go. Nice job. Oh, nice
Long
play by
chicks it in deep. Who's out front?
There it is.
Keith's out front. Can't
you know
get
what?
Any wood on
we
it.
We are inches away from just firing that thing, and we just can't get it off.
Missouri collects and looks to regroup.
So far, EB's carrying the play. We just got to get more shots on Smith.
Well, we just got to get the puck on the net, right, John? I mean, that's like, call me the master of the obvious, but.
Yeah, that's always a good idea. And we're only skating two lines. The Warriors are skating at least three, maybe four. I'm trying to check it out.
And the Colonials just look like they have a little extra jump to me tonight.
Oh, nice move.
And here comes
Alex, get it off. Can she get that thing off? She's getting mugged.
Getting mugged,
oh, in
going
front
to the net. The ref won't call it. Collected by Cardarelli.
Oh, Leah to the net, y'all.
Elena Cardarelli mugged in the corner. No call by the referee.
tough bounce. Nice job by Melissa. Swing it. There you go. Nice job. Right up the boards, right there. Oh, they're trying to let it go. Can Elena get there?
High sticks all over the place. No call.
That was almost like a sword fight. Oh, she's got some wheels. We got a 2-on-1. Good job by Leah to get back. Nice poke check
awesome
by LaBlunda.
Unbelievable play by Alex LaBlunda to break up that odd man
very
rush.
Very nice, very nice. Watch in front of the net.
The odd man rush. No icing. Odd man rush created by the very aggressive play by the Athens in their offensive end.
McCready's taking the hit. Oh, right down the.
Squirts down the boards. Missouri retreats to collect.
Oh, nice job. Can she beat it? Can she take the corner? Caitlin can.
Little give and go out of the corner.
Look at that. Stick it, baby, stick it.
Too much traffic in front of the net. No room to move.
That's one thing the Warriors do really well.
Corner, cycles it back in.
One thing the Warriors do really well, they forget about positional play, and they get
away
to the front of the net.
John, they've got all five players packed in beneath the hash marks.
They packed the front of the net.
And Caitlin Juan taken down viciously in the corner, and that results in a penalty.
So, Mikey, we had the PK, which AB is, like, phenomenal this year, over 95% on the kills. Now we go into the power play, which are about, like, somewhere around 33%. Let's see if they can get that shot off.
33% is a solid power
play
percentage.
That's huge.
So Fontas rolls out the number one power play unit, and let's see what they can muster up here. 2:06 to go in the first period.
Ah, too bad. Who's going to get there? Somebody's going to get there.
Looks like a...
Oh, nice play. Wow.
That looks
like
a hockey drill.
Skate, baby. Skate, you got a 4-on-2. Come on, somebody should be open. Oh, we got to get a better shot than that.
Carter
we
got to
get a better shot
net
than that. That
Smith
was a
keeps
4
the paddle
on
down
two
and smothers the puck.
That was a 4-on-2.
1:49 to go in the period. 1:13 remaining on the power play situation.
I think Leah might have been a little tied, honestly. Because we just went from a PK to a power play. Basically the same players are on the ice.
Missouri goes the length of the ice to collect.
One thing we can't take again, we can't get into
an
another special
collision
team. We can't get another special team situation. We got to get back rolling the lines. These girls are beat up.
Roach with a dipsy do at the blue line, always dangerous. Cardarelli wheels to the middle, and here comes Missouri with a bomb.
You got to launch that puck. She could have taken all day to shoot that puck. Nice play by Atlanta. Shoot it.
Here's the ball. Save out front.
Oh, wow. That was nasty. Stay wide, Roachy. Stay
in
wide.
And two Colonials out front, but no rebound.
That was a good
Smith
play by Smith.
Controls the rebound. 50.5 seconds to go in the period.
We got to get a change. These girls have been on the ice for 3 minutes. Get them off the ice.
Here comes the change. 15 seconds to go in the man advantage.
Oh, but Barrett's still out there. She's got to be dragging. Let it go.
Here comes
LaVonda
from the point with a drive. Ah. Wide.
Uh-oh. Can you get there? Melissa's got good speed. She'll get there. Well, she's getting a little hooking.
Sets her edges and turns the corner.
Ooh. Oh, almost. That's a nice. Okay.
25.9 seconds to go. Both teams back to full strength. We're going to have a face-off in the Colonial attacking end.
So what do you do right now? Do you fire it at the net, or do you try to drop it back and get the slap shot from the point?
I think you tie it up and you have the offside winger by the board cut through the dot and fire a shot.
So plow straight ahead and take the face-off, the center out? The Golden Warriors center out?
Center ties it up, leaves the puck there. Battling in the corner. Cardarelli, both Cardarellis battling, taking on two Warriors.
12 seconds.
Time winding down, 7 seconds to go.
Nice pitch.
LaVonda holds it in.
Oh, can you get there?
2 seconds to go, and that's going to do it for the period.
Well, Mikey, honestly, AB kind of dominated this period. Not a lot of shots on net. You know, remarkably enough, I think the puck was down their end the majority of the time. Not a lot of shots on net, but, you know, I think Smith made about, you know, what, say 8 to 10 saves, and, you know, we carried the play. So if we can keep this up, keep the pressure on, sooner or later they're going to find the back of the net.
I agree, John. We definitely outskated it, but we don't have enough to show for it.
By the way, what do you think of this turtleneck?
That's a good look.
That's a good look. That's good.
Did you buy that at a garage sale?
Here. Goodwill. Hey, see you next period.
Welcome back for the start of the second period. Your Colonials in a dogfight here. 0-0 tie. Puck about to drop on the second.
Even though we dominated, Mikey, you still want to see that first one get through, right? He's going to call that icing? Oh, huh? What's that?
Tough way to get the period started. Face off, and the Colonia's defensive end.
What was that call?
Ice.
If he had it. Oh, okay, okay. I thought Missouri made the red line. If she missed it, she missed it by 6 inches.
Cardarelli on the draw, puck loose. Missouri controls and steams out of the zone. Rattles off the post.
So you think that hit the post. Nice job.
McCready's keeps it in to Roach. Battling along the boards.
We got one D back on that. Watch out for this ice. I don't think this ice is cured up yet, Mikey. Ooh, heads up. Watch
trouble.
The front of the net. Oh, man, we locked out. We locked out right there. Oh, did Cali get that or did it just miss?
I don't know, but it looks like the Colonials are standing flat-footed so far this period.
We are. We got to get going. Wow, we're like out of position. Nice job by Cali.
Somebody's in the net.
You got to get her out of the net, don't you?
One of the Warriors is in the net. That counts as being in the crease, doesn't it, John?
I don't know. Does Cali get credited with the save when there's somebody standing behind her? Wow, that was weird.
So 13:56 to go.
Well, they're taking the puck outside the zone. I think it's going all the way down.
They're taking it all the way down.
Oh, maybe not.
Just outside. Oh, right. He's herding them back into the zone.
Maybe that player got pushed into the net. Maybe he has to get flying. Nice job by Alex to get that out of harm's way. Uh-oh. Ooh, Cal had a toe out.
Deep into the corner.
Uh-oh.
LeBlondo with a harmless little bump.
Maybe. Uh-oh. I'm telling you, Andover's flying. Quickly, right around the boards. Right around. Nice job.
LeBlondo chips it out. Here comes Wong.
This ice
feathers it into the corner.
Get to the front of the net.
Keith hustles up and gets it.
Hong. Oh, too bad. Somebody shoot it.
Traffic jam in front. Nowhere to go.
And the Golden Warriors come out with it.
Held in by McCready. Down to Hong in the corner. Looking for somebody out front. There's Barrett wide open. Oh. Shot. Is it in?
She squeezed him.
Smith squeezes the pads.
Five hole and she squeezed it. That was a good save right there. Tough save.
That was an outstanding scoring chance.
Nice pass too by Caitlin to bop it right out front to Megan Barrett.
So Cardarelli on the draw for the Colonials. Back to Batez.
Oh, Ming.
Danny battling into the corner.
Nice job by Ming. Oh, good pop-up.
Cardarelli carries it back into the zone. Missouri looks to reset.
That puck is just not moving. This ice is terrible. To Wolanski, good back check by Leah Cardarelli right there, Mikey. Good back check.
That was good hard work.
And that puck
Cardarelli
just
tries to dig it out of the corner.
Quickly, nice job,
Missouri.
Nice job, Annie.
Desperately ices the puck, icing is on. Face off down in front of Callie LeBlondo.
Nice play by Annie.
A little bit of a slow start for the Colonials.
You know what, you don't want her thinking too much in front of the net like that. Just get it out of there. Good play by Annie, smart. And you know what, the Golden Warriors, they're rolling four lines, Mikey. This is their third line right here. Gonna pay dividends in the third period. We gotta get a couple goals this period. Nice job, Caitlin. Wow, how'd she get that through? Uh-oh. That was out.
That's definitely out. And the Warriors regroup.
A little change in the play right now.
Momentum has definitely changed, no question.
And it seems like we're a little out of sorts, right? You know, like not playing positional hockey.
And there goes we're going to go for a penalty. McCready's.
Yeah. Andover, I don't know what what the Andover coach said to these guys, but these guys came out flying. They're controlling the play.
Short, is he running his first and second line out there?
Well, he's running. He's
is
running
he short
three
the bench?
Lines. At least three.
So 11:26 to go in the second period. Colonials find themselves shorthanded.
Thank God she didn't drop that back to the point, which would have been a smart move. Oh, I saw this. A lot of nice save
big
by Leah Cattarelli. Too much traffic in front of the net. Oh, look at that. Just give it to him. That's going to get out of there.
That's nice. Out.
We're even out of sorts on this PK, Mikey.
Usually
look at we got three girls standing together right there. Nice save.
Save
by
LeBlondo, big save. Wrapped around the boards and not quite out of the zone by Missouri.
Wow, that puck just stuck on that stick, huh? We gotta hustle. We're not hustling, we're kind of standing around. Nice job by Leah. Nice job. Oh.
And there's
a call. He's gonna call it. Stick to the face.
So 36 seconds to go on the shorthanded situation, and Andover's whistled for a penalty.
What is the downside of having back-to-back penalties like this? We are going to see the same four girls out there, man, and these girls are going to be beat up. Oh, good. He's pulling Leah off. That's a good move. Leah's coming off. Actually, we got four new troops out. Oh, let it go, Annie. I don't think Smith saw that at all, Mike.
Did not see it. She didn't move. It was there.
Somebody get to the front of the net.
Barrett taken down in the corner.
Nice pinch.
LeBlondo comes up with the puck.
Nobody's going to the front of the net. We got three people standing at the blue line.
Icing on the play.
Really? Is that what we need?
Colonial's a little out of sorts, Sean.
Why are three people standing at the blue line on a 4-on-4? Come on now.
10:02 to go in the period. In 7 seconds, the Colonials will have a power play for 50 seconds. And here we are. Man advantage for the Colonials.
All right, let's go, guys. Skate it in, Leah. Skate it in. Nice job. No. Okay. Get it to an open area.
Now work
quickly
it around.
Quickly pass it. Minkia, Johnny. Wow.
Both teams having trouble handling the puck.
The first thing you should be doing on the power play is you should be looking to pass. Looking to pass immediately. Don't forget about the stick handling. Look to pass. Let's keep the puck moving.
I think Leah handcuffed Smith a little bit with that puck. She couldn't control the rebound, but managed to pounce on it. Refs blew it dead. 23 seconds to go in the man advantage situation.
All right, let's get the puck moving and let's get a good shot off here, right here. Move it quickly. There you go.
Back
nice.
To Barrett.
Quickly.
Barrett watch it down out. The middle.
Yeah!
And Barrett finishes it off.
Nice job.
Boom!
Nice job. Right there. Elena Cottarelli in front of the net. Setting the screen, Barrett knew she was there, fired it into an open spot.
So the power play works wonders for the Colonials. And they've managed to mount a 1-0 lead.
Nice job by Barrett, that was a great shot.
Well, she was waiting for resistance.
And
there
nobody came to her.
She walked it in and let it fly. Smith and never saw it.
She didn't see it at all.
Now you just gotta hope you don't have that post-goal letdown.
Yeah, right. There you go. Chip it out. Get it up the ice. Nice job.
Caitlin feathers it into the corner, and who's there? Megan Barrett, fresh off of the goal.
Oh, hey, Caitlin with the backhand. Oh, nice
Keith.
Dish.
Oh! Score!
Caitlin Hahn, 2 assists. The goal! Wow. Caitlin Hahn's on fire.
And the the Colonials, finally getting what they deserve after outskating these Warriors for 2 periods. It's about time, Johnny.
It's about time, and they're putting them on. That was a tough shot. Smith didn't have a prayer to save that one.
The Warriors don't know what hit them. They're a little stunned right now. They're shocked. Shocked.
That was a one-timer by Keith. She just popped it right into that open spot, and that's an icing. Well, what was the over on this game?
5 goals.
Is that what you had?
The over was 5 goals. I heard the score 4-1.
Oh, from Vinny the Fish?
Joey the Finger.
Richie the Finger?
Richie the Finger. Oh, right there. You gotta get there, Al. You gotta get there. Nice job. Oh, wow. Elena made a play and a half. She doesn't make that play. That's a Warrior standing right in front of the net.
Yeah, did you see the ref setting that pick? Missouri bumps her off the puck.
Leah Cottarelli might be a little messed up.
Tired?
She just went down. No, she just went down.
McCready's battling along the dasher.
Nice job.
And here comes Roach.
Nice play by Roachy to get a stick on it.
I don't know what you're talking about. Leah looks fine.
Oh, beat her, Roachy, beat her.
Going hard into the boards.
Set the edges. Here comes
Melissa. And here comes McCready's on the pinch.
Oh.
Chipped out. And Andy Missouri looks a little gassed.
That might be a shot on net.
No, and that's
no,
an ice.
You got it. No, that's not icing. Oh, here comes
Keith. Waved it off. Oh. Keith hustling right. In.
To the net. Okay, nobody home. Who wants it? That girl's stick is either broken or it's made out of metal. Number three, listen to when she touches the puck. Take a look. Nice job.
Just gets out of the zone. Fired back
kick
in
out.
By
watch
the Warriors.
Kick watch the kick out.
With the dreaded Colonial bounce off the door, that usually works in our favor.
Uh-oh. Oh, nice play by LaBlunda right there. There was a Golden Warrior sitting right on Palm's way. You know, hold the line.
Colonial's hanging on to the puck a little too much. You can hear Fontas yelling for them to move the puck.
Oh, they're letting
Ice
that
is
one
waved
slide
off
too.
Again.
We got to get somebody to the front of the net. Caitlin Wong, an assist
Caitlin
machine.
Caitlin in hards, collects the puck.
Good feet.
Who's in the middle? Who's cut down the middle?
Good pass, D to D. Ooh.
Batez collects it.
Good little pass to Megan.
Barron out front to Keith.
Also known as Phyllis Mazzito.
She does a remarkable job of.
With the one-timer.
Oh! Cottarelli tries to sneak one in on the back post.
That was a nice play. That was
and
a
that's
nice
an ice.
Play. Not only
I think Maggie's got a stone, they have to skate after it.
Not only did Elena have a nice shot on the back post, Keith was standing on that back post and just couldn't get a stick on it.
So Colonials with a 2-0 lead, 6:18 to go in the second period.
I'm gonna come out and say that these guys, this line's gonna score right now.
Oh.
Get in front of them. Okay, here we go. Skate, baby, skate.
Here it is, John. Even it's 2-on-2.
Nice job.
Missouri regroups and looks to get it restarted. Feathers it into the corner. Fresh legs for the Colonials.
Beautiful. Nice change right there. That was a good change. Good steal by Elena.
Cottarelli tough along the boards behind the net.
Oh, nobody home.
Looks to get it out front. Nobody out
right
front.
There, right
perfect
there.
Feed to McCready.
Get a tip on it.
She lets it go right off the squash at 22 for the Warriors.
And we got this girl's got legs. Oh, nice play. Nice play by Melissa. Leah's got some wheels going.
Sets her edges, gets it off, it's deflected.
Ooh, Keith,
oh, look
right
at that!
There. Oh!
Nearly put it in, John. Your prediction almost came true.
I'll tell you, Smith Bailey made that save. We got a 2-on-1. Good poke check right there. Now the pace is picking up a little bit now, Mikey.
Puck bouncing around willy-nilly here, going all over the place.
Oh, I
feel like
a hook.
Feel like I'm watching tennis.
That might be a hook and a half.
LaBlundo goes for the home run pass. Keith's got a turn.
And Smith's going to
tie it up. That was not Keith. Having trouble differentiating the Smurfs tonight. That was Caitlin Wong.
But it was a nice play by Barrett. Barrett kind of slowed it down and, and chipped it off the board.
And Alex Luongo made a nice pass the length of the ice to present it perfectly right in front of Caitlin Wong.
Nice job. Now we got to get the forecheck going again.
Cycling deep.
In. Oh, nice poke check by Caitlin.
We seem to do a lot better, John, when our D are aggressive, stepping up, don't you think? Shot controlled by Luongo.
Oh, and look at McCready's. McCready's just pulled out a club and said, "You're not coming near my goalie."
That looks like another night at the dinner table, John. No surprise there.
What did you say to me, Melissa? They're taking her off. They don't want her to kill anybody. So even though we're skating two lines, these guys are doing pretty good.
Wrapped around the boards.
Watch your back.
Roach collects it. Winds up behind the net.
Take it, Roachy. Oh, heads up. Roachy's just cleaning house.
And that was just the case of being in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Are they going to call that? Oh, they're going to call it? That was kind of,
interference on them.
Oh, it's interference on them.
No, but that's how I saw it.
Yeah, I don't think Roachy hit that girl on purpose. I think she was just in the way.
Well, I guess the ref thought it was interference, John. I disagree. 3:55 to go in the second period. Colonials once again shorthanded.
Mikey, it's a big difference going into the third period. Up two goals.
And John, I don't like this penalty killing behind the net like this.
I don't like that at all. Now Missouri's going to be very tight when she comes out of that corner. If you're going to do that, you got to do that down the other end. Just flick it out. That girl, Leah. Leah's so smart. Oh, nice poke check.
Cardarelli rides her into the boards.
We don't want that
borderline.
Ooh.
What's going on there?
Oh, heads up. Oh, no. I think Luongo drew a penalty.
That's going to be on them.
There goes Atlanta. Can Leah take it the length of the ice?
Off the ice.
Oh, Banyard. Here goes Missouri. Missouri's going to let it go. Go the distance.
She's got to get that puck. And Leah got away with one here at center ice with it. Did you see that?
Yeah, oh yeah. You ever notice how the games start out with not a lot of penalties the first period, and then when we get to the second period's where all the penalties occur, and then the third period it calms down again.
And they start playing hockey.
Yeah.
Second period, they're gooning it up.
Oh, they're gooning it up, and you know, all our special teams players are all beat up. They're all beat up in the second period. Because they're on the ice constantly.
Just a little footnote, the movie Goon on Netflix during the snowstorm.
Oh,
hysterical.
The best.
Did you see it?
Oh, the best. Ooh, that was a nice quick snapshot.
So I guess it's 4-on-4 for the next 26 seconds. And then Colonials will have roughly a minute power play man advantage situation.
A little off the boards to Elena. Nice try by Megan. Nice little pirouette by, are they going to call an interference? Nope. Cover that 10 in front of the net. Oh.
Great nice save job. By Callie. And Roach right out of the penalty box.
Uh-oh. This girl's kind of nifty. Get it out of there. You got to get it out of there.
And Luongo closes the door.
Nice save. Nice save by Cal.
That was a great save. In perfect position. Kept the paddle down.
Pads out. Were butterfly perfect.
No room in the five hole.
Nope. You don't want to give that five hole goal. I'll tell you. Honestly, I don't want to see Cal give a five hole goal because then I got to listen to it for a friggin' week at my house.
So 2:13 to go in the period. The ref's going over to sort out the time on the Andover penalty, which they never put up on the scoreboard.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Charlie Priest. Hey, man.
We got Joey Lowe in the house.
Executive producer, Joseph LaBlunda.
So Colonials are going to have a 40-second power play situation. Andy Missouri wheels out of the zone. An ill-advised pass, nearly intercepted.
I'd like to see them just carry it in. Just carry it in. Somebody, yeah, get it to Leah. Let Leah carry it in. Nice and easy.
Offsides all over the place. I think they were anticipating her to fire it in, maybe. I don't know what was going on there.
No, the best thing to do is carry it in. Get it over. Get your teammates across the line and then stop moving the puck
quickly. Colonials control back to Missouri.
There you go. Nice pass by Missouri over to Roaches.
Has trouble controlling. Missouri looks to reset.
All right, somebody's got to carry it in. Carry it in, Roche.
Roche is getting hooked. Don't give it back.
If you can get unhooked. Oh, nice save.
Deflected off the defenseman.
Nice job by Leah.
Stay tuned between periods for our exclusive fan of the game feature.
Five on five right now. Now we got like a four. If she doesn't get to that puck, it's like a three on none.
A minute 15 to go and a little ragged power play here for the Colonials.
It's not a power play anymore. If Annie doesn't get to that puck, it's a three on nothing.
Yeah.
And she's dying right now. She was on her last breath getting there. Get there, Melissa. Strong on the puck. Good job.
Chips it out of the zone. Warriors need to clear.
Nice take. Oh. Can she get it to
pass?
Nice try by Alex.
She's
good always vision. Looking deep.
Good vision the length of the ice
always
by
looking
Alex.
Deep. She's got that quarterback in her. You know, my brother was a quarterback way back when.
Your brother gave me a quarterback the other day when I needed a 25 cents change on a $5 sandwich. 57.5 seconds to go in the second period.
You couldn't have been at 20 if it was a $5 sandwich.
Good point.
Okay, we just... look at that! Oh, my.
Crazy bouncing puck.
Can you believe that just happened?
Is he calling a penalty? Melissa was taken down.
This is...
Oh, what did he call? He called an ice. What about the trip?
This is the bewitching hour right now for AB goalies and AB teams.
It's getting a little ragged here, John. 39 seconds to go. Let's just get to the locker room without any damage.
I know. This is a big face-off. Oh, Leah really, really has to win this face-off. Oh, nice shot. Get it, Roche. Clear it out. Nice job. Get it deep. Oh, yeah, she's going to cut her off. Nice job.
Off.
20 seconds left in the period.
Period winding down. Colonials looking to.
Oh, no.
I know it makes you nervous, but Carl's not here to yell at her.
Wow.
Right into the pads of the defenseman.
I'll tell you, this number nine at one point must. Oh, just missed the post.
2 seconds to go, and that's going to do it for the period.
Good
period. So the second period ends. Big period for the Colonials. Two goals.
Nice
job. Colonials up 2-0.
All right, we'll be back after the words from your sponsors.
Welcome back for the start of the third period. Colonials find themselves with a 2-0 lead
in
this battle for the DCL Conference Championship.
They come
march
along.
To the championship.
I'll tell you. They had about the same amount of shots as the first period, Mikey, but they got a couple home.
Well, we were talking about it during the break.
I know.
They didn't play as well in the second period, but they got two goals.
Well, hopefully this will be a much better period for us. Less PKs, less power plays, because I think, oh, wow. Nice play by Alex McCreezy to get that out of
harm's
way.
Heads up play to get the puck out of the way.
Oh, geez, a lot of shots on net. We're getting a lot of shots on net by our own team so far this period.
Who shot that one at her? So fresh legs for the Colonials.
That's coming. A lot of screen. Heads up. Wow.
Barrett almost tipped it in.
I'm telling you. We're getting a lot of shots on net by our own team this period. Tough bounce.
And they got numbers going
to the front
on
the net. To the front of the net.
Oh, Melissa just got those feet in the way.
Wow, Cal, you can't let them get there. Chip, nice job.
Colonials have yet to get the puck in their attacking zone.
No, we haven't touched the puck past the red line yet. Quickly, quickly. Skate, 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 skate. Nice job. All right,
there
we're
go.
In.
We finally got it in.
And we're out. Watch out for that puck. Watch out for that puck. Oh, the old turnaround. The old turnaround.
And dicey times for the Colonials.
I think the pivot behind the net should be left for a different sport. Never pivot behind the net.
And I think that's what the coach is saying now. Fontes' face is red like a beet. Missouri carries it out of the
nice
zone.
Nice job. Nice job by Annie.
Ooh.
Almost.
Roach in the corner on the puck, collected by Cardarelli behind the net.
Nice poke check by Leah. Poke. Yeah, that cleared the zone.
And just offsides, whistled dead, face-off outside the Colonials' attacking zone.
You know what? The pink laces, the skate laces, those look good, Mikey. Play for the Cure. This is a great fundraiser. Susan B. Coleman, and we got another fortuitous bounce, but we're just not there.
Roach gets his stick on the puck, able to keep it in. Good effort by Lauren. And here comes Andover.
Nice job, Maggie.
Ooh. I kind of get the feeling we're just chucking it out of our end every time we get it, don't you?
Yeah, maybe playing like the prevent defense, you know what I mean?
That prevents you from winning?
That prevents you from winning. Well, I think she's kind of offside there. Quickly. Oh, no. Wow, nice
save by Callie LeBlondo. Flash in the letter. Here comes Barrett.
Wow, this number 10 is shot out of a cannon. Makes to her. She's throwing a banyada. Heads up, heads up. Yeah, a lot of snap. that was a roundhouse there, wasn't it, Roachie?
Barrett fires it up the boards. Nobody there. Open Warrior standing right in the middle.
Nice job by Keith.
Good job
using
by Keith to tie her up.
Skate. And we get it out of the zone, and it's back in.
Boy, the Colonials are
bottled up
on fumes here. Not sure what's going on.
Well, you knew that was going to happen. Andover's skating four lines. We're skating two. So this is going to be, oh, man. We got a two-on-none right now. Nice.
Great
poke
play
check
by Melissa. Stuffs everybody in the net.
Nice play by McCready's. But it's one great defensive play after another because they're getting shots.
LeBlondo dancing across the blue line with the puck.
Wow, there's just like nobody back on D. It's crazy.
Nice save LeBlondo on the short side.
We are like totally out of position. There's nobody back on D. I don't understand, Mikey.
11:13 to go. Colonials.
Timeout.
Clinging.
Yeah, good call by
to
Fontes.
To a two-goal lead, and Brian Fontes calling a timeout to try to get them reeled in.
Probably a good time to, like, maybe drink a Gatorade, maybe a five-hour energy.
Yeah, five-hour energy for everybody. The Colonials really look like they're on fumes with a few dicey moments in front of the net.
We haven't seen the puck down their zone yet. We haven't seen the puck down their zone yet.
What's Brian saying to them, John?
I think he's just saying play positional hockey. Let's get the puck down into the offensive zone. Let's get our forecheck going. and let's keep the puck off of Cali.
That's pretty complicated. I think he's probably just saying, hey, get your junk together.
Something like that.
And get your head out of your pocket.
Start skating hard.
So 11:13 to go.
Would it be
the Colonials right off of a fresh off of a timeout to regroup.
And
more of the same.
Yeah. Look in front of the net. Look in front of the net. This is looking bad. Oh. Wow, we lucked out on that one. That was an icing. Wow, it's just constant. We cannot get the puck through the central zone. You know what?
Roach gets the puck on edge, fires it up to Cardarelli, and it looks like Colonials are going to get it in the attacking end for once.
All right. Oh, Leah, nice job. Pass back to Allie. Oh, heads up. Let's hold it down there. Good job. Good job to hold it, girls.
Cardarelli feathers it in deep.
And then let's get some quick changes, too. I'd like to see quicker changes. Get these girls off. That was a nice quick change right there, Mikey.
And it looks like the Colonials have kind of regained some sense of hockey here.
Yeah.
For the last couple minutes.
After the timeout. So, you know what? Honestly, good timeout by Faunus. Oh, here we go.
Use a point. Here comes LeBlondo with a bomb.
Tipped up. Oh, right there, Keith.
Puck bouncing in front. Colonials
Keith
can't
just couldn't
control
get a
it.
Stick on it. Good pinch. Good pinch
held
by
in
LeBlondo.
By LeBlondo.
Watch it, watch it. Can you get there? Can you get there? Nice job. Cali stretching
out. LeBlondo with a spectacular save.
Oh, right through. We look tired, Mikey. We look tired.
And I think we're running out of steam. They haven't had practice for 4 or 5 days, John. Cardarelli goes around the team.
Leah still has some energy. She going to go one on five? Nice job holding it down. A smart play to hold it deep. Good pinch by Rochi. Hold the line.
Blocker save
the
LeBlondo.
Oh, right in front. That puck seems to get in front of the net a lot this period, Mikey.
McCready's controls. Tries to get out of the net.
And she clears the zone.
Manages to battle.
Nice job by Atlanta. Is she going to take the corner? Can she get it off? Nice back check. Good back check. Wow. Elena's working hard down there. Good job by Allie to keep it deep. Oh, nice job. Wow, somebody's down. Who's down? Now she's up. Is that Rochi? Oh, Elena almost got a piece of that. You still doing play-by-play? What are you doing?
7:46 to go.
What the hell are you doing?
7:40 to go. Colonials up 2-0.
I know the game's exciting, but you can say something.
I thought you took over for a minute. You stole my microphone. So here comes Keith.
I'm just saying stuff because nobody else is talking.
Missouri wraps it around the boards.
And they hold the zone again.
LeBlondo looks for open ice. Oh, dangerous pass, but
nice
very
chip.
Fortunate for the Colonials. And here comes Long through the crowd. Tied up on her feet, can't control it.
Megan, nice job. I'll tell you, Andover's got a... They got some life in their step.
They sure do, and the Colonials are looking a little tired.
Oh, wow. Cali just held the post on that.
McCready's wraps it around. And look at Cardarelli at the far. Oh, geez. Frisbee. What a saucer pass.
Oh, wow. And then back the other way. Oh, a little Phil Diddle action.
And Gouging saved by LeBlondo.
Nice Carol job.
LeBlondo standing tall, carrying the Colonial Superior, John.
It's big period, big period.
6:22 to go. Colonial's looking a little rubber-legged to me. What do you think?
All right, we got Batez out there, so now we're starting to rotate that fifth D through. It might be time to, like, run. What do you think? Should they run that third line through? I mean, to get some action there.
Batez battling in the corner, still battling. Puck comes free. Missouri controls.
Nice
up to
shot.
Roach.
Skate it up, Roachy. Nice pass right
Roach
on the tape.
Roach ready to tape to Cardarelli.
I don't think Smith has Smith seen a shot on net yet this
Not
period?
Much. Ooh. Roach wheels out of the corner.
She almost hit Leah going to the net. Nice job by Annie.
And Roach comes up with the puck again. Charity hop to Leah Cardarelli off the boards. Loses it with a toe drag.
Right,
so here come the Colonials looking to regroup.
Let's get a change. Oh, nice job.
Look at Keith single-handedly.
She's going to let the P go.
Oh, and a big shot off of Smith. Rebound.
She's carrying the play.
No lack of energy from Keith.
Oh.
Through the crowd.
That hit Kevin right in the elbow. Nice job, Alex. Nice job. It keeps down. Melissa's just manhandling.
I'm not sure what's going on
in front of the net,
but there's definitely some physical play.
Nice job,
shoveled
by Caitlin.
Out of his
Here
own.
We go. Hitting
and the neutralized by Caitlin.
Can she beat her? Oh, nice.
4:43 to go in the period. Colonial
nice
still clinging.
To a 2-0.
To a 2-0 lead.
Ooh, Elaine almost took it. Nice pinch by Alex. Nice play. Beautiful
play
right
by
on the stick.
Here comes Barrett with speed down the wing.
Can she take the corner? Leah Cardarelli was going right to the net.
And you've got three Colonials wide open. Barrett taking on four Warriors.
And they finally dig it out. Oh, right on net.
McCready's gets it to the net. Gloved by Smith.
That looked kind of ugly, didn't it?
Trapped it with the glove.
Yeah. That looked kind of ugly.
And it was inside the corner of the post and had a chance of going in.
That'd have been goal number two.
4:06 to go in the period. Colonials mustering up all the energy they have.
Nice job. Get it deep. Oh, they're going to call that. That's terrible.
And that's what the Colonials did not want now with their penalty killers on fumes.
Oh, yeah. They got to get new life out there.
And you almost know it's inevitable, John, when your team is tired late in the period.
Okay, so they're going to bring Barrett out, and they're going to bring Leah. So that's not bad. They got three fresh bodies out there. The only one that was out on that ship was Leah. Nice job, Annie. Nice job.
And
Annie
Missouri
clears it the length of the
sends
ice.
Sends it the length of the ice.
And they're in good position right now, too. They're not all weird
Warriors
right now.
Warriors control, looking to get it set up.
Oh, nice poke check. Wow.
There we go.
Oh.
Boy, that was close, John. I thought Megan was off to the
she
races.
She was gone. She was gone.
But that's good penalty killing. Valuable seconds coming off
Megan's
the clock.
Megan's got a hand on the grill. Fighting.
3:27 to go in the period. A minute left on the shorthanded situation.
Wow. Exciting game. A lot of action. There we go. Get it deep, Meg. We're gone. It's going to be a 5-on-3, Mikey.
For 42 seconds. So Missouri called for the hook. The Colonials coming unglued.
Yeah. 5-on-3. Now, if you're Andover, do you pull the goalie?
Tyler Andover.
I wouldn't be surprised if they pull the goalie. They're going to have a 6-on-3. This isn't going to be good. Andover calls a timeout. Greg, Coach Greg Manning, Steve Arnold's buddy.
I don't see him hauling the goalie in.
No? Well, 5-on-3 is good enough, right?
5-on-3 is plenty. It's very tough to defend. You just got to hope you can get the puck and fire it out of the zone a couple times. Only 42 seconds of 5-on-3. In reality, our penalty kill's pretty good when we're one man down.
Yeah. When we're one man down.
So we just got to get back to one man down.
Right. The main thing on this is the one time a slide across. If we can prevent the one time a slide across, let them take the shots from the perimeter. Forget about the one time a slide across, because that no goalie's going to get that. 10 times.
3:08 to go. Colonials find themselves in a 5-on-3 for 42 seconds.
So we're going with one defenseman and two forwards.
And he's resting the others for the penalty kill when this is over.
All right, back to the point. And here we go.
And the Baltimore penalty to number 26 in Missouri. Right on penalty for hooking. Time for the call.
Keep it back there. Nothing
can
happen.
Nice job by Leah. All right. What a nice play by Leah Cottarelli to get that puck out of there. Get it out.
Seconds winding off the clock. 23 seconds left on the 5-on-3.
Don't let it get to the net. Nice poke check. Oh, another nice poke check. Leah is single-handedly killing
off the 5-on-3. 10 seconds left in the 5-on-3.
Nice, and she chipped it out again. Beautiful. They got to take it in. They got to have one guy skate it in. All right, that penalty's over. We're now 5-on-4. We got Elena Cottarelli out. Let's get into the box, girls. Nice poke check.
Elena's going to get it out of there. There we go.
You know
33
what I say about,
seconds left on the man down.
You know what I say about poke check?
Poke check, paycheck.
Poke check, cross check, paycheck.
21 seconds left on the power play. Andover trying desperately to get something set up, and Cottarelli steals it. Boy, I would have liked to see her dump that down into the corner, John.
Wow, this girl's another poke check.
Leah Cottarelli standing him up at the blue line.
And another poke check.
And that's it. We need to get our skater back on the ice. Roach calling for the puck.
Right there.
There she is
tip.
Out of the penalty box.
We got a 2-on-1 ski.
Get it over to Missouri.
Annie
Missouri.
Annie Missouri almost popped that home. Nice little pass. Back to Missouri.
Missouri with a bomb from the blue line.
Whoa! That almost saw its way to the corner there, Mikey.
And the Colonials playing with some newfound enthusiasm here. 1:09 to go. Feeling like the king of the world after killing off the 5-on-3.
I think they can see the end.
Last minute to play the penalty. Last minute.
Nice play.
Move the puck, Annie. Annie's got it pinned on the dasher. This is the play we talk about hating, John. That puck always pops out into the crease.
As long as we back that up, Melissa's going to shoot at the length of the ice.
And that's going to goalie's going to have to play it? No, it's going to be an ice.
That's going to be an ice. All right.
We'll take it. 28 seconds to go. Faceoff going to be in the Colonials' defensive end.
Well, I'll tell you, Mikey, tough period for the Colonials, but they held in there. You know, a couple of good shots on Cali. Good penalty kill on that 5-on-3.
So now Brian going with 4 forwards and 1 defenseman.
Interesting. You think that's pure tiredness?
I think he's going for the stick handling skills of Leah.
Nice
but
job.
Boy, you like to have those defensive instincts out on the ice. 13 seconds, and this is going to do it. The Colonials are going to escape with a convincing 2-0 win, John.
I'll tell you, well earned.
This is a big win for the Colonials.
Well earned.
Let's hear it.
Mikey, well earned 2-0 victory against the Andover Golden Warriors.
Everybody played well. Callie carried the team in the third period.
I think she forgot. That was probably one of her better periods of the year. Right there, she came up.
So
huge.
No rest for the weary as the Colonials take on league arch rival Westford Thursday at Groton Academy.
Wow.
Until next time, sign off.
Ciao.